Hi everyone, welcome back. In this tutorial, I will show you how to customize the working days and hours in Blazor Scheduler component. In this video, I will showcase the various features of the scheduler can be customized. It inherits almost all calendar-specific features, including the ability to set working days and hours, along with choosing the start day of the week. I will also cover how to display week numbers, customize hours, hide weekends, and scroll to specific times and dates. First, let me open the existing Blazor WebAssembly app where I've added the Syncfusion Blazor Scheduler component with the T-value property bound to the Appointment Data Model class. If you want to learn how to get started with the Blazor Scheduler component, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. You can also find this example by following the link in the provided description below. Let me run the example application. Look now, the scheduler renders with provided week view. By default, the scheduler considers the weekdays from Monday to Friday as workdays, Saturday and Sunday as weekends. Now, I will show you how to easily set working days and customize them in the scheduler. By default, the scheduler considers Monday to Friday as workdays 1 to 5. To customize the working days, first, I declare an array variable of type int, named working days, and initialize it with an array of 1, 3, and 5 to represent Monday, Wednesday, and Friday respectively. Then add the workdays property and bind the working days array to it. See here, the week view displays only the defined working days on the layout, while other views display all the days and differentiate the non-working days on UI with an inactive cell color. Next, I will demonstrate how to hide the weekends in the Blazor Scheduler. The Show Weekend property controls weekend visibility in a week view. In the Workweek view, non-working days are not displayed. Days not included in the scheduler's working days collection are typically seen as non-working or weekend days. To hide weekends, set the Show Weekend property to false. Look now, the weekends and non-working days are hidden. Next, I will demonstrate how to show week numbers. To display the week number count in the header bar of the scheduler, set the Show Week Number property to true. Look now, the week numbers are displayed as the first column. Next, let us move on to the different options for showing week numbers. By default, week numbers are shown in the scheduler based on the first day of the year. However, the week numbers can be set based on the following criteria by setting the week rule property. There are three options: first day, first 4-day week, first full week. Here, I will implement the first 4-day week rule. To enable this, I simply add the week rule and set it to the first 4-day week. Now, you can see the week numbers displayed based on the first 4-day week rule in the scheduler. Next, I will show you how to set working hours in the scheduler. Working hours indicate the work hour limit within the scheduler, which is highlighted with an active color on work cells. The working hours can be set using the schedule work hours, which includes the following sub-options: highlight, start, end. Now, I define the schedule work hours tag and add the highlight property, setting it to true. Additionally, set the start and end properties to define the start and end time of the working hours of a day. Now, you can see that the working hours from 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. are defined working hours, so they are shown in active color. And remaining hours are shown in an inactive color. Next, I will demonstrate how the scheduler displays custom hours. It is possible to display the event scheduler layout with specific time durations by hiding the unwanted hours. To do so, I set the start hour property to 7 a.m. and end hour property to 6 p.m. Looking here, the scheduler displays the time range 7 o'clock a.m. to 6 o'clock p.m., and the remaining hours are hidden on the UI. Next, I will demonstrate how to set the start day of the week. By default, the scheduler marks Sunday as its first day. To change it to a different day, I add the first day of week property to scheduler and set it to Wednesday, numeric value 3. Now, you can see the scheduler displaying Wednesday as the first day of the week. Next, I will demonstrate how to scroll to a specific time and date in the scheduler. To get started, I declare the time value variable of type DateTime and initialize it with a new DateTime. Additionally, I declare the component reference named SchedulReference and add the ref attribute to bind it. Using the SchedulReference, I can access the built-in method called scrollToAsync to scroll a specific time and date. Next, to display the time picker, I use the Syncfusion Blazor Calendar's namespace. Then I define the span tag inside the division tag to display the text as scrollTo. Then define the sfTimePicker tag and set the tValue property to dateTime. Additionally, set the width and format for the time picker and assign time value to the bindValue property. To automatically scroll to a specified time, define timePicker events within the Blazor timePicker component and set the tValue property to dateTime and add the value change event. In this event, I will bind the event handler, which is responsible for automatically scroll to the specific time and date. To achieve this, I create the public async method named onValueChange, which takes the parameter as changeEventArgs. Inside the method, I call the scrollToAsync method from SchedulReference to manually scroll to a specific time on the scheduler. Finally, I bind the onValueChange method to valueChangeEvent. Now you will see the time picker above the scheduler. I adjust the time picker and set the time to 12 noon. Notice that the scheduler automatically scrolled to 12 o'clock noon. This behavior allows users to easily navigate to different times based on their selection. Now let me summarize what I covered in this video. I covered how to customize the working days and hours. Additionally, I covered how to change the start day of the week, show week numbers and custom hours, hiding weekend days, and scroll to a specific time and date. For more information on scheduler's features, click the documentation link provided in the video's description. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.